Yes, you are.
What is the Gauss divergence theorem? Priyanshu?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the Gauss divergence theorem? It was given in exam. I told you all, only three chapters were given. I told you all that go through my PPT. It was given in the PPT. What is Gauss divergence theorem? Stokes theorem and Gauss divergence theorem. Two theorems were there. And what you have written? You have written divergence of P equal to zero. This is the Gauss divergence theorem. It was written in PPT. Is it? The syllabus was, that is not very big syllabus for class test. Only vector and waves, that is SHM and damped and force only was included in your syllabus. Still, say something. You have to say something. You have to explain why you have done this. Priyanshu, what happened? Tell me, what is Gauss divergence theorem first? Anyone can tell me? Just give me, anyone. What is Gauss divergence theorem?
Ma'am, Gauss divergence theorem is...
Sneha, shortcut, tell me. What is Gauss divergence theorem? In this theorem, you have also solved problems. Volume integration and surface integration, you have done this also. In this way, Gauss divergence of theorem is proved. I have also discussed problems on this theorem. So say, what is Gauss divergence theorem? And I am just saying, all of you, every day, 2 to 3 students, for there will be some questions, and if you can't give answer, I will put cross marks against your name. And when I will give internal marks or any mark, then I will consider this cross and tick.
Ma'am, the divergence theory of Gauss.
And in internal marks, what will be your internal marks? Then I will say that you have. I have asked 5 questions to this student, and he or she has given only 2 or 3 answers. In this way, every day I will check. Say, only 3 to 4 chapters, only topics were given in exam. I said that follow my all the PPTs, but you have not followed. And still you can't give answer. Sneha?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the divergence of Gauss can be defined that if V is the volume.
The relation between which?
Ma'am, relation between
integration is.
Ma'am, relation between volume bounded by a closed surface A and A vector, the vector function.
It was written in PPT. Now after you have passed your class test. Class test has now after your class test. This is your answer. And Priyanshu, now tell me you.
Yes, ma'am.
Priyanshu Barman, one problem was given. Okay. So no unit you have to check. That formula that you have written 1 by R root over L by C. And L was given in different units, C was given in different unit, milli, micro. So you have to consider all these things. Milli is 10 to the power minus, you have not considered that. Inductance was 1 millihenry and capacitance was micro in microfarad. And what you have done? L by C, that is 1 millihenry divided by that microfarad. You should do that 1 millihenry means 1 × 10⁻³ henry. But you have not done this. In micro, milli, you can't calculate like this. Do you know that or don't know? And what you have done, Priyanshu, second thing, the general formula you have not written. The general formula you have not written for that quality factor. Quality factor has some general formula, and you have taken the approximation. When resistance is very small, then what will be the approximation of quality factor? Only that formula you have taken. Why? And Gauss divergence theorem you have not written. You have written, you have proved divergence of E equal to zero. From where you have this one, divergence of E equal to zero? From which book you have? Tell me. Priyanshu, say something.
Ma'am, from एक senior से book लिए थे.
तो हम तुम्हें बोले थे कि senior से book लेके पढ़ो. हम क्या बोले थे? तो पीपीटी जो दिया गया है, जो पीपीटी अभी बहुत सारा बुक को मिला के किया गया है, मेरा अपना पीपीटी है, तो एक बुक का नहीं है वो बहुत सारा बुक का है एक साथ, तो वो तुम क्यों नहीं पढ़े? हमने इंस्ट्रक्शन दिया था कि पीपीटी को ठीक से पढ़ो, तो तुम क्यों नहीं पढ़े हो अभी? बोलो, give me the answer. And your electrostatics, that is not included in your syllabus. Seniors का जो syllabus था तब different था, तो तुम senior से क्यों लिए हो? ये तो उन लोगों का syllabus में था, अभी तुम लोगों का syllabus में ये सब इतना details में नहीं है. तुम बोलो, तुम्हें जवाब तो देना ही होगा. You have to give the answer. Why you have not followed my PPT?
Ma'am, I followed.
Followed?
Yes.
So it was not written Gauss divergence theorem there?
Yes, ma'am.
Should I screen share that part, Gauss divergence theorem in vector?
No, ma'am.
Then why are you saying that you have followed? Directly you have not followed. This proves. So you have only 20 out of 30.
Okay, ma'am.
Dilshan? Hello, Dilshan?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
So you have different excuses every day. That day your excuse was that with camera it is not possible to give the exam, so I screen shared the question paper. Now your problem was solved. Now today you again join late, 8 minutes late. Why are you late? So I am just warning you all. I am noting down every name, everything, whatever you are doing. We may be in online mode, but I am noticing everything. And noting down everything.
Ma'am, आज पहली बार है जो मैं 8 मिनट लेट हुआ.
क्यों हो लेट?
मैम, मैं कनेक्ट कर रहा था 11-2 से, बट हो नहीं पा रहा था. पता नहीं क्यों आज पहली बार है मैम जो 8 मिनट लेट भी हुआ.
अभी और एक आ रहा है. ये सौरभ. Now Saurabh, why are you late? You are 16 minutes late. Why?
Network is not working properly. I don't know why, ma'am, but not working.
What?
Ma'am, network is not working properly.
Okay, network problem. Okay, now your problem is solved. Tell me what is the value of divergence of R? It was given in MCQ.
Sorry, ma'am, repeat.
Do it in your paper and tell me what is divergence of R. And in my class, I have solved this one.
In one of my class, I have solved this one.
The divergence of R. Have you written right thing there or not in answer script?
Ma'am, I think I left that question.
So listen, everyone. If you are not following what I am saying. If you are not obeying my words, then you will be in big problem, very big problem. If you have online examination or offline, offline examination is there, then totally in physics you have totally you have 100 marks here in theory, 30 is internal and 70 is extra, that is in semester exam. If it is online, then everything is your total, it depends on your internal marks, and you can think what will be your condition. If you all irritates me in this way, then what will be your condition, that think about it. Repeatedly I said, follow the PPTs. Everything is given from my note, everything. And after your marks, I am just checking the marks, and I will share it in your Google Classroom again. After checking, then those students will score very low marks, I have to inform your parents also. Then I will call one video conference with your parents that you have done this. Divergence of R, I solved this problem here, and why I gave this problem is because these are frequently given in semester exam, frequently given problem. So what type of problem is given in my PPT, they are very important, very very important, because they are very important for your semester examination. So leaving the my PPT and notes, you are following the senior's notes, and this is your condition now, Priyanshu. Still I have given steps marks. If I give, if I totally, if it's zero, then you should have scored 15. तुम लोगों का कुछ पढ़ना जरूरत नहीं था. तुम लोगों का सीनियर्स जो था पहले आईटी में, आई एम टेकिंग द फर्स्ट टाइम इन आईटी, प्रीवियसली आई वाज टेकिंग इन सीएससी एंड ईसी, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कंप्यूटर साइंस. मेनी मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट स्कोर ओ, दैट मींस 90 to 100. And they only said that I have followed that, that was the offline time, that offline exam, and not the online classes. They only said that they have followed my classes and my lectures. तुम लोगों का जैसा कोई कोई है जिसका तो बहुत नॉलेज बहुत ही ज्यादा है, ठीक है, टीचर जो बोलते हैं उसको तो सुनना नहीं है, तो उन लोगों का कंडीशन ऐसा ही होता है. And totally I will give whenever I will, if it's totally in online mode, that is last time what happened, totally the no offline exam was there, totally marks was given from the university total through the total internal evaluation. And if it is, what will be your condition, just think about it. One student will get 40 D, that is 40 to 50 only pass marks. And another student will get excellent or extraordinary. Or outstanding, she or he will get. And one will get 40 to 50 or 50 to 60. So just think about your condition, what will be, it will be latter. So I will check. I was checking the copies and I was just thinking that I said these things and you have not followed these things. ठीक से सुनो, तुम लोग ठीक से पढ़े नहीं हो, ठीक से रिजल्ट नहीं हुआ है, तो आज तुम लोग इस कंडीशन में हो. 12 के बाद बहुत सारा ऑप्शंस होता है, IITs होता है, उसके बाद NITs होता है, उसके बाद बहुत सारा है कॉलेजेस है, उसके बाद कुछ किसी में भी तुम लोगों का हुआ नहीं. तो दैट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ यू हैव पढ़े हो, तुम लोग पढ़े हो 11-12 में, पर कैसे पढ़े हो ये देखो. अभी भी यहां पर भी आके कॉलेज में आके नहीं पढ़ रहे हो, टीचर जो बोल रहे सुन नहीं रहे हो. तो इसके बाद आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग बीटेक व्हाट विल बी योर कंडीशन, जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. क्योंकि देखो बाद में तुम लोगों के इंटरनल में तो बहुत खराब मार्क्स मिलेगा, ठीक है, तो खराब मार्क्स मिलेगा तो तुम लोगों का पेरेंट्स को भी जानना चाहिए कि मेरा लड़का टीचर का कोई भी बात सुनता नहीं है, स्टूडेंट्स को कोई भी बात सुनता नहीं, इसलिए ऐसा हो रहा है. एवरीथिंग आई एम नोटिंग, कौन क्लास में देर से आ रहा है, कौन क्लास में रेस्पॉन्स नहीं कर रहा है, सब कुछ मेरा रजिस्टर में रजिस्टर होता जा रहा है. और बाद में सभी का जब टोटल सम लिया जाएगा तब व्हाट विल बी योर कंडीशन, जस्ट थिंक एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट बिहेव योरसेल्फ. तो तुम लोगों को पढ़ा के फायदा क्या है बोलो ना, इतना पढ़ा के इतना सब कुछ करके फायदा क्या है यार. आई विल से एट द पीपीटीज, नो नीड टू कैलकुलेट इन व्हाइट बोर्ड. इन व्हाइट बोर्ड आई कैलकुलेट व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ आर. नाउ दिस इज योर कंडीशन, यू आर राइटिंग रॉन्ग थिंग, देन व्हाई आई शुड डू दैट. I am doing that so that you for easier for understanding, but you are not following. Whiteboard में कौन सा class में हो रहा है देखो तो follow करो. Whiteboard में कौन सा class में हो रहा है. Physics का तो बहुत सारा stream है, बहुत सारा class है, देखो तो हम भी बंद कर देंगे whiteboard calculation. जो PPTs में है पढ़ा के चले जाएंगे. तुम लोगों का तो बहुत सारा फ्रेंड्स है, सीनियर्स है, बहुत सारा है इन्फॉर्मेशन, तो तुम लोगों के पास कम कुछ नहीं है, बहुत इन्फॉर्मेशन है. अभी देखो सीएससी में देखो, आईटी में देखो, सभी में देखो, अभी व्हाइट बोर्ड किस में कौन हो रहा है, क्या कैलकुलेशन हो रहा है देखो, पूछो. हम भी नहीं करेंगे, हम भी बंद कर देंगे. अभी पढ़ोगे नहीं तो हम करके क्या करेंगे क्या. गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम के ऊपर हम प्रॉब्लम कराए, उसके बाद भी थ्योरम लिखा नहीं गया, कहां से वाइट तुम लोग. बहुत सारा कॉपीज हम चेक किए, सभी में डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ आर 0-1 ऐसा करके आंसर आ रहा है. एक्चुअली द आंसर इज 3. ठीक है, तुम लोग बहुत समझदार हो, तुम लोगों का पढ़ाई में कोई भी इंटरेस्ट नहीं है, तो हमें इतना इंटरेस्ट क्यों है तुम लोगों के लिए. जैसे करोगे वैसे हम पढ़ाएंगे. तुम लोगों का पढ़ना में इंटरेस्ट नहीं है, हमें भी पढ़ाना उतना अच्छे से नहीं है. हम पढ़ाएंगे और उसके बाद ऐसा ऐसा लिखोगे जाके एग्जाम में, तो तुम लोगों का फायदा क्या है. तुम लोग तो पढ़ना ही नहीं है, सुनना ही नहीं है, ड्राइविंग करते करते कोई क्लास करते हो, कोई सोते सोते क्लास करते हो, कोई भी पूछते हैं कि लास्ट क्लास में कि आप बता नहीं पाते हो, तुम लोगों के लिए करके फायदा क्या है. जैसा हो स्टूडेंट वैसा ही पढ़ाएंगे हम नेक्स्ट दिन से. आज से व्हाइट बोर्ड बंद. एक टीचर जब पढ़ाते हैं, जो स्टूडेंट्स जो खराब करते हैं ना, टीचर को बहुत खराब लगता है कि हम पढ़ाए उसके बाद भी ऐसा किया. हम बोल दिए क्या करना है और क्या नहीं करना है, उसके बाद भी स्टूडेंट्स लोग ऐसा किए. पता ही नहीं है कि पेरेंट्स को बात नहीं सुनना, टीचर को बात नहीं सुनना, तुम लोगों को कितना इंटरेस्ट कितना अच्छा लगता है ये हमें पता नहीं है. तुम लोगों के पास दिमाग होता तो तुम लोगों का तो फ्यूचर सुधर जाता. तुम लोगों के पास दिमाग ही जब नहीं है तो सुनना चाहिए ना टीचर का. अपना दिमाग लगाने के कौन बोला है कि तुम्हारा दिमाग लगाओ. तुम लोग अपना अपना दिमाग लगाओ. टीचर ने बोला है क्लास करने के लिए करना है, टीचर ने बोला है पीपीटी पढ़ने के लिए तो पढ़ना है. तुम लोग अपना अपना दिमाग लगाते हो, नहीं पीपीटी से नहीं पढ़ना है, इधर से पढ़ना है, उधर से पढ़ना है, और इधर उधर से पढ़ के ऐसा हाल होता है. ठीक है, हम तो ये मार्क्स अभी चेक कर रहे हैं, एचओडी के पास तो भेजना है, प्रिंसिपल के पास भी जाएगा ये मार्क्स. और तुम लोगों का पेरेंट्स के साथ हम अलग से मीटिंग करेंगे, जिसका बहुत खराब मार्क्स आएगा उस स्टूडेंट्स लोगों के साथ हम मीटिंग करेंगे पेरेंट्स के साथ, और बता देंगे कि इन लोगों का फ्यूचर में बहुत घटिया मार्क्स आना है, और अब प्रिपेयर रहे घटिया मार्क्स के लिए. फर्स्ट ईयर से ही ऐसा है, बाद में क्या होगा पता नहीं. हाँ, तो ये इन्फॉर्म कर देना है, क्योंकि पेरेंट्स का जितना एक्सपेक्टेशन तुम लोगों के ऊपर है उतना एक्सपेक्टेशन वो रखे या नहीं रखे उन लोगों को भी तो जानना चाहिए. समझ गए सभी? जस्ट कॉपी चेक होने दो, उसके बाद पेरेंट टीचर के साथ मेरे साथ मीटिंग होगा तुम लोगों का पेरेंट्स का. और वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस में होगा जैसे गूगल मीट में होगा. I want to talk to them directly and I have to inform them about the performance of the students. देखो आज जो था वो है मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन का सेकेंड लेक्चर है, पर तुम लोगों का जितना हाल है तुम लोगों से ये होगा नहीं. ठीक है, तो हम वो पीपीटी हम शेयर कर देंगे, वो पढ़ लेना मैक्सवेल सेकेंड इक्वेशन. ठीक है, क्योंकि जो इतना इजी इजी क्वेश्चन नहीं बता पाते तो उसके लिए वो प्रूफ सॉल्यूशन और बहुत सारा, और करना भी नहीं क्योंकि ये ऑनलाइन मोड हो और कुछ भी हो तुम लोगों का बस की बात नहीं है. वो तब नोट दे देंगे, वो पढ़ लेना मैक्सवेल सेकेंड इक्वेशन. अरे ऐसे भी तुम लोगों को पढ़ना नहीं है. पढ़ के करोगे करोगे भी क्या? देखो मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन में स्क्रीन दिख रहा है?
Yes,
दिख रहा है या नहीं दिख रहा है?
Yes,
ये था गॉस लॉ. ये गॉस लॉ और गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम सेम चीज नहीं है. ये गॉस लॉ और गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम सेम नहीं है. ये गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम दिया गया था और तुम लोगों का बोला गया था कि मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन लिखो जाके. रो जीरो हो गया तो डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ ई जीरो हो गया. प्रियांशु को हम बोल रहे हैं, तुम्हें बोला गया था कि मैक्सवेल इक्वेशन तुम लोगों का सिलेबस में है? It was written Gauss divergence theorem and you have written Gauss law from electrostatics. That is not included in your syllabus. So ये सब तो जो question था last दिन Maxwell's equation चारों क्या है? ये चार Maxwell equation है, इसका differential form ये है. Maxwell equation in vacuum और free space ये सब क्यों? Grad square equal to mu zero epsilon zero del 2 E by del t square. This is very important. I'm saying if it is given in, maybe given in also next semester question. This one very important. Electromagnetic wave equation in free space reduced for 3 marks. And it is not also the second one not will be given through your only Google form because you have to deduce. And everything you will get in your return Google Classroom. Every line I have checked. Hard copy की तरह तुम लोगों को लगेगा कि every line check किया गया है, कहाँ पर क्या problem है, कहाँ पर काटा गया है mark, सब कुछ पता चल जाएगा. जैसे copy check होता है वैसे किया गया है. हम बोले थे C equal to 1 by root over mu zero epsilon zero. This is very important, frequently given in MCQ and this question. 90% आने का chance है. ये सब ये portion. हम डिस्कस कर दिए हैं. और ये जो पार्ट है नेक्स्ट आफ्टर दैट द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ वेव इक्वेशन. तो ये तुम लोगों का मेरे मुझे लगता है कि डिस्कस करना तुम लोगों के समझोगे वो भी एक प्रॉब्लम है क्योंकि मैथमेटिकल ये नॉलेज को क्लियर करने के लिए है, ठीक से नॉलेज गैदर करने के लिए है. पर ये तुम लोगों का इतना बड़ा आता नहीं है, पर कैसे होता है क्या हुआ है सॉल्यूशन कैसे इसका स्टेप्स है ये सब देख रहे हो, हम शेयर कर देंगे. उतना इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है, इम्पोर्टेंट है मतलब इम्पोर्टेंट बहुत ही है पर तुम लोगों के एग्जाम में आने का चांसेस कम है इतना बड़ा पोर्शन. तो फॉर दैट रीजन इफ आई गेट टाइम एट लास्ट देन आई विल डिस्कस. And nature of electromagnetic wave, the oscillatory components of electric and magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other. And the oscillatory components of electric and magnetic fields are mutually perpendicular to the direction of propagation. These two things are important. These two things may be given in MCQ. And conclusion is electromagnetic wave is transverse in nature. So the nature is very important. And the solution that I have discussed here, the solution of Maxwell's equation. ये देख लेना, the wave vector k points in the direction of propagation. This is the direction of propagation. This is the wave vector. Now let the wave is propagating along the x-axis. So you can see the wave is propagating along the x-axis. Electric field E is oscillating along y-axis. So along y-axis, electric field, this is shown. This is the y-axis. The electric field is oscillating along y-axis, and the magnetic field is oscillating along z-axis. Okay. So this is the z-axis magnetic field. You can see this is B. Magnetic field is oscillating. Magnetic field is oscillating along z-axis. Then we can say that is the propagation vector or wave vector k. K equal to E cross B. So k equal to E cross B. Electric field, magnetic field, and the propagation form a right-handed triad. So that is this is shown here. So this is the for the electric field, this blue line. This line B is for the magnetic field, and this is the propagation vector. So this is along the this direction, along this direction. This PPT I will share. तुम लोगों के हम एक बात बता देते हैं, हम जो भी बोलते हैं स्टूडेंट्स लोगों के भलाई के लिए बोलते हैं, पर इसके बाद मेरा बात नहीं सुने ना नेक्स्ट दिन से, तो तुम लोग तुम्हारा जितना खराब इंटरनल आएगा उसके लिए तैयार रहो. जो भी नहीं बात सुन रहे हो मेरा वो तैयार रहो, क्योंकि हम जो भी बोलेंगे तुम लोगों के भलाई के लिए बोलेंगे. तो तुम लोग नहीं सुन रहे हो मेरा बात तो तैयार रहो कि बहुत ही घटिया मार्क्स मिलेगा. नाउ दिस इज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इस, हम बोल दे रहे हैं कि इससे ज्यादा अभी जो क्वेश्चन आता है सेमिस्टर में ऑफलाइन हुआ है उतना ज्यादा क्वेश्चन इसमें से आया नहीं है, पर एज इंक्लूडेड इन योर सिलेबस सो आई एम डिस्कसिंग दिस थिंग. सो मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल्स है, ऑल मेटेरियल्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इन टर्म्स ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक बिहेवियर फॉलिंग इन टू of five categories depending on their bulk magnetic susceptibility. The two most common types of magnetism are diamagnetism and paramagnetism, which account for the magnetic properties of most of the periodic table of elements at room temperature. These elements are usually referred to as non-magnetic, whereas those which are referred as magnetic are actually classified as ferromagnetic. So ferromagnetic materials are actually magnetic materials. The only other type of magnetism observed in pure elements at room temperature is antiferromagnetism. Finally, magnetic materials can also be classified as ferrimagnetic, although this is not observed in any pure element but can only be found in compounds such as mixed oxides, ferrites, from which ferrimagnetism derived its name. Now this is the periodic table and different colors are shown here. You can find out the colors. White is for paramagnetic materials. This color is for ferromagnetic. This is diamagnetic materials. So you can see this portion is are all diamagnetic materials. White portion, this is a paramagnetic material, and this portion is ferromagnetic. That is, you can see, ferromagnetic material. And these are paramagnetic material or white portion. That is, this is paramagnetic material. So Fe, this portion, say Fe, cobalt, nickel. So these are ferromagnetic. You know, iron is ferromagnetic material. So Fe, cobalt, nickel. This is ferromagnetic material. And antiferromagnetic is only chromium here. Antiferromagnetic material. That is only chromium here. And all the white portions are paramagnetic material. So if it is given, give the examples. So from this chart, you can give the examples. So, and this portion is totally diamagnetic materials. So you have to give the examples and you have to know the examples. What are paramagnetic materials? Paramagnetic materials have some unpaired electrons, and due to these unpaired electrons, the net magnetic moment of all electrons in an atom is not added up to zero. So due to that unpaired electron, magnetism appears. Hence, atomic dipoles exist in this case. On applying external magnetic field, the atomic dipole moment aligns in the direction of the applied external magnetic field. Initially, when I was discussing dielectric material, then what was happening there? In dielectric material, what is dielectric polarization? Say, what is dielectric polarization? In the same way here, polarization is here also, but for magnetic moment. What is dielectric polarization? In dielectric polarization, which field you will apply?
External electric field.
And for which one you will apply? External magnetic field. External magnetic field. Okay. So on applying external magnetic field, the atomic dipole aligns in the direction of the applied external magnetic field. In this way, paramagnetic materials are here magnetized in the direction of the magnetic field. In simple words, you can say that these materials usually experience a weak attraction to magnets. That is, paramagnetic material has weak, they experiences a weak attraction to magnets. This type of magnetism is known as paramagnetism. It occurs mainly due to the presence of unpaired electrons in the material or due to the partial alignment of randomly oriented atomic dipole along the field. So why the paramagnetism appears? It is given in last two lines. It may be given in MCQ also. Paramagnetism appears due to 1, 2, 3, 4 options. So you have to know. And what are the examples of paramagnetic material that you have to know? So it is mainly paramagnetism occurs due to the presence of unpaired electrons. Remember this one. Then paramagnetic material or paramagnetism can further be two types. First type, the magnetic moments are found in low concentration, which leads to its separation from one to another. Their spins also do not interact. This screen is visible or not?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
So this is for the first time the spins do not interact. In the second type, paramagnetism occurs due to the interactions between the magnetic moment. In this case, the interactions are very weak. Therefore, there is no net magnetization when the applied field is zero. This type of magnetization is based on Curie's law. According to that law, paramagnetic materials, magnetic susceptibility chi is inversely proportional to their temperature. So remember this one. This is the Curie law. M equal to chi H. Chi. And chi here it is magnetic susceptibility. And for dielectric, what was chi? Same thing. Susceptibility. The definition is also same. Here it is magnetic susceptibility. And in dielectrics, what I was saying about chi, what is the name? Here chi is magnetic susceptibility. In dielectrics, what is chi? What is chi? Say.
Deceptive.
Electric susceptibility. Aurithro, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Aurithro Bosch, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, in mobile, I got your message. I was asking about that. So this is the Curie law, M equal to chi H. Remember this expression. So what is M? M is the magnetization, chi is the magnetic susceptibility, C is the Curie constant, and T is absolute temperature, and A is auxiliary magnetic field. So remember this one. What is Curie law? So this is C by T into H. This also can be written like this. So M equal to chi H. Actually, in detail, you will not get any question. Probably, you will not get short answer type question. You may get. Then super paramagnets are the elements that are only show a net paramagnetic response, but they also tend to exhibit strong ferromagnetic or ferrimagnetic ordering, mostly at a microscopic level. These materials also follow Curie law and have very large Curie constants. Ferrofluid is a super paramagnet. So which material obeys the Curie law? You can say that is paramagnetic material. And also the super paramagnets, ferrofluid is the example of this. Now the diamagnetism. In a diamagnetic material, the atoms have no net magnetic moment when there is no applied field. Remember this one. Under the influence of an applied electric field, the spinning electrons presses, and this motion, which is a type of electric current, produces a magnetization in the opposite direction to that of the applied field. All materials have a diamagnetic effect. However, it is often the case that the diamagnetic effect is masked by the larger paramagnetic or ferromagnetic term. The value of the susceptibility is independent of temperature. So in diamagnetic material, you must have to remember that the atoms have no net magnetic moment when there is no applied field. Now ferromagnetism is only possible when atoms are arranged in a lattice and the atomic magnetic moments can interact to align parallel to each other. This effect is explained by classical theory. So these are given actually in details. So to go through it. So ferromagnetism in the periodic table, the elements only Fe, CO and nickel are ferromagnetic. And I discussed the periodic table, and only these three are the ferromagnetic material. And which was antiferromagnetic? Tell me. Antiferromagnetic material, it was given in that periodic table. And I also said
chromium.
So these three,
chromium.
Chromium is antiferromagnetic. Okay. So the two students have given answer. What are the names? Just you two. Just tell me your names.
Richa.
Richa. Okay. And. And.
Kanchan. Kanchan Sarkar.
Okay. That proves that you have listened whatever I am saying. And every day listen my lectures very carefully. When I will ask the names, and if I particularly ask to a particular student any question and you are not giving answer, then I am noting the names. Remember this one. And whenever I will give marks, your class, for depending upon the class performance, you will get marks later. So your class performance also very important. So this is the ferromagnetic materials. Now antiferromagnetism. In the periodic table, only the element exhibiting antiferromagnetism at room temperature, this is chromium. Okay. Antiferromagnetic materials are very similar to ferromagnetic materials. So just some lines are here. So just go through it. Here one temperature is important. This is nil temperature. Like ferromagnetic material, these materials become paramagnetic upon a transition temperature. So ferromagnetic, like ferromagnetic materials, these materials means antiferromagnetic materials. Antiferromagnetic materials becomes paramagnetic above a transition temperature. And this is known as nil temperature, TN. It is noted as TN. Now, this is about the ferrimagnetism. For example, so just go through it. And I said that detailed question answer, you will not, in semester, you will not get questions from here. Just short answer type questions. What are the definitions? These are important. So just go through the PPTs. and here it is shown in a chart. It is diamagnetism, paramagnetism, ferromagnetism, antiferromagnetism, ferrimagnetism, all are shown here. Their properties, the examples are given. And here the magnetic behavior also shown. Magnetic behavior, see the figures here, see the pictures for paramagnetism, the orientations of the magnetic moment, these are shown. You can see that is randomly oriented here, but in ferromagnetism all are oriented in a particular direction here. You can see my antiferromagnetism, this is upward direction, this is downward direction in this way. So this is the antiferromagnetic material and this is for ferrimagnetic material. So in one single chart, all their properties, examples are shown. And M and H, what will be the curve, MH curve for diamagnetic material, what will be the curve, MH curve? Already I have discussed what is M and H. So this curve, what will be the type of the curves? It has been given. So what is the time? So about 20, it is 11:48, okay. Next, magnetic susceptibility. The definition, magnetic susceptibility is a dimensionless property like electrical susceptibility that I discussed in dielectric material when I was discussing dielectrics. There you got electrical susceptibility, just like same here, magnetic susceptibility. This is a dimensionless property, dimensionless proportionality constant that indicates the degree of magnetization of a material in response to an applied magnetic field. So this is the about magnetic susceptibility. It is caused by interactions of electrons and nuclei with the externally applied magnetic field. Magnetic susceptibility measures how much a material will be magnetized in an applied magnetic field. So this is the role of magnetic susceptibility. Now the magnetic susceptibility expression, chi, you already know, chi is the magnetic susceptibility. And what is chi? Chi equal to M by H. So chi is the magnetic susceptibility, M is the magnetization, and H is the field intensity. So this is the relation between M, H, and chi. Then for paramagnetic materials, magnetic susceptibility chi is greater than zero, which means it is always a small positive value for paramagnetic materials. For diamagnetic materials, magnetic susceptibility chi is less than zero, which means that it is always a negative value for diamagnetic material. And for ferromagnetic material, magnetic susceptibility is very high and positive and depends on the applied field. So if you get MCQ question, you also can get about magnetic susceptibility. So the magnetic susceptibility for different magnetic materials, paramagnetic, diamagnetic, and ferromagnetic. So for paramagnetic, it is greater than zero. For diamagnetic, it is less than zero. And for ferromagnetic, it is very high and positive value. So magnetic susceptibility for ferromagnetic material is very high and positive. And it also depends on the applied field. So these are all of today's discussion. Time is over, so I'm not discussing much here. And I'm just warning you all again, whatever I'm discussing in my class, just go through it. And in every class, I will ask questions and I will note down the names, and who are not giving answers, I will just give cross mark against your name, against their name. And at last, I will count the crosses and then think what will be your condition for your marks. So this is my warning to you all. And whatever I am just suggesting, that if I suggest that go through the PPT, you will read the PPT. If I say that these problems are very important, you will read these problems. You will calculate these problems. So obey my words. Obey whatever I am saying. Then you are all in safe side. Otherwise, problem are waiting for you all in near future. Understand? Say something.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so whatever I am saying, just follow that. Follow. Only follow. तुम लोगों को क्या करना है क्या नहीं करना है ये सोचना भी नहीं है, हम जो बोल रहे हैं वही करना है। मैम जो पढ़ा रहे उसको छोड़ के सीनियर्स का नोट ले रहे हो, हाँ सीनियर्स का नोट ले रहे हो जो सिलेबस में ही नहीं है, तो ऐसा ही कंडीशन होगा बाद में, सो डोंट डू दैट। Now, the attendance. Roll number one. Roll number one. Roll number one. Am I audible or not?
Ma'am, he is present, but his mic is not.
So, roll number one. Two.
Present, ma'am.
Three.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Present, ma'am.
Five.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Seven.
Present, ma'am.
Eight.
Present, ma'am.
Nine.
Present, ma'am.
Ten.